So, you're a Mac user, and you finally made the decision to start creating online videos. Exciting. But there's a lot of decisions to be made, like which video editing software should you use? Well, if you have a Mac, most likely it came bundled with the video editing application iMovie. But is iMovie enough? Find out, coming up. Hey, it's Mike with more tips and tools to help you create engaging, informative, and educational video. And if it's your first time here, make sure to hit the big subscribe button and don't forget to click the little bell icon so you don't miss a thing. Editing is probably the most challenging and intimidating aspect of video creation. To do it well, you need both a firm grasp of video storytelling and the ability to effectively use video editing software. But which video editing software should you use? I mean, there's a lot of choices out there. Well, if you're a Mac user, you already have a video editing application sitting on your machine. It's called iMovie. Many people overlook iMovie as a serious video editing application. They think it's just a simple tool to make home movies. So is iMovie capable of more polished, professional-looking videos? Well, having been a professional video creator for close to 30 years, I can tell you that professional looking has less to do with the tools and more to do with the technique. Having said that, there are certain pro-level features that I look for in video editing software. Let's see how iMovie stacks up. An important feature I look for in video editing software is color correction. Color correction tools allow you to fix strange and distracting color effects in your video, usually caused by your lighting or incorrect white balance settings on your camera while recording. iMovie has a simple, built-in color correction feature that allows you to adjust the brightness, contrast, and color saturation of your video. It also has a color temperature shift control. This is especially handy when you're trying to correct improper white balance in your footage. Clip speed controls are another thing I look for in video editing software. This feature allows you to speed up or slow down a video clip. Speeding up a video clip is a great way to show the passage of time, particularly if what you're showing takes a long time but needs to be shown, like an important process. Slowing down a video clip is an effective way to show the viewer important information or details in a shot that would otherwise be hard to see because the action is too fast, like sports training, for example. In iMovie, you can both speed up and slow down your clips. Multiple video tracks is a must-have feature. Having multiple video tracks gives you incredible flexibility when it comes to editing. You can use additional video tracks to easily add cutaway footage, or what's known as B-roll, into your project. You can use additional video tracks for popular effects like picture-in-picture, split screen, and green screen. iMovie lets you do all of those things, but you have to do it using only one additional video track. Complex 3, 4, 5 layer compositing effects aren't possible in iMovie. However, for the vast majority of videos you see online, iMovie's dual track multimodal editing system is more than adequate. Another important feature I look for in video editing software is high quality on-screen text. We use on-screen text to deliver a lot of information in our videos, from titles to lower third IDs, to captions. You don't want to have to use a separate graphics application every time you need some nice looking text in your video. Having a solid text engine built into your editing software saves you a lot of time. iMovie comes with an assortment of nice looking on-screen text templates for titles, lower thirds, captions, and credits. And many of these templates are already animated for you. But you can't customize them very much. You can select different fonts, sizes, and colors, but you can't change the text's position on screen, for example, which is kind of limiting. But with some imagination, iMovie's built-in templates can go a long way. But what if you need to display custom text elements or graphics in your video? To be able to do that, your video editing software needs to be able to import and use graphic files. And that's another feature I look for in video editing software, the ability to use graphic overlays. Graphic overlays are essentially custom images or graphics you create in other applications that you can bring in and add to your video project. But in order to use graphic overlays, your video editing software needs to be able to use graphics that contain transparency information, or what's called an alpha channel. Only certain image formats support an alpha channel, the most popular formats being PNG and TIFF. iMovie can import both PNG and TIFF files, including their alpha channels. Keyframe animation is a feature you may not think of as being terribly important in your video editing software. Keyframe animation allows you to move objects around the screen, determine when they appear or disappear, or shrink or grow. Having a keyframe animation system built right into your video editing software, no matter how basic it is, will save you loads of time, because you won't have to use a separate, dedicated animation program like Adobe After Effects, for example, to create even the most basic of animations for your project. iMovie has a keyframe animation system buried within its picture-in-picture feature. It's pretty bare bones and not very intuitive. Once you figure it out, you can use it to create some basic animations. Okay, let's talk about one of the most vital ingredients in any good video: audio. People will put up with subpar video quality if the sound quality is decent, but not the other way around. Bad sound can make a video unwatchable, which is why when I look at video editing software, I pay particular attention to its audio features. Like, does it have audio meters? Audio meters tell you if the sound level of your video is too low, in which case your audience will have a hard time hearing things, or too high, in which case your sound may become distorted and unusable. Audio meters also provide you with a sound level reference. Keeping the sound level of all your videos at this reference point means the sound levels in all of your videos will be consistent, which is good. You don't want to force your viewer to constantly adjust the volume of their speakers while watching a bunch of your videos. iMovie does not have traditional audio meters. Instead, it uses a waveform and color coding to gauge sound levels. Another audio feature I look for in video editing software is the range of audio filters available. Audio filters can help fix and enhance the sound elements in your project. iMovie has a collection of basic audio filters. It has an automatic optimize filter that essentially boosts and evens out weak sound levels. There's also a suite of noise reduction and equalization filters to help fix common sound issues. But I think one of the most important audio features to have in your video editing software is multiple audio tracks. Multiple audio tracks allow you to add elements like voiceovers, music, and sound effects to your project. These elements can really make your videos more engaging. iMovie allows you to create multiple tracks of audio, so you can have multiple tracks of music, voiceovers, and sound effects. But this would quickly become a sonic mess if you had no way to control the volume levels of all these different tracks. In iMovie, you can adjust the sound levels of individual clips over time using keyframes. This is a fairly precise and easy-to-use method for controlling sound levels. iMovie also has a sound mixing feature that will automatically lower the sound levels of all the other clips on the timeline in relation to the selected clip, a process known as ducking. So, after going through all of those features, is iMovie a capable enough video editing application? Well, for the vast majority of the types of videos you see today, I'd say iMovie is more than adequate. Sure, it's limited, particularly if you're creating longer form videos or videos with a lot of effects or animations. But even then, you could create that kind of content in a separate, more capable application and then easily import it into your iMovie project. When you take into account the price point, feature set, and ease of use, iMovie is a fairly solid contender. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found value in it. And if you want to discover more tips and tools for creating engaging, informative, and educational video, click the subscribe button on the screen so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.